Okay, my name is Michael, and I love Jesus with all of my heart. My journey started a couple years ago. I struggled with addiction for 10 years, and my story started in jail, solitary confinement, reading the Bible, getting to know Him. This year in January, I really dug my heels in deep. And I started to give my life to Him, and I confessed that He was my Lord and Savior. I invited Him into my heart, and He made Himself very evident. And I have been obsessed with my book and obsessed with this relationship ever since I was saved and reborn. So I don't know, like many of you who love Jesus, I pray every single day. I keep my eyes open. I look for these messages. I look for His face. And I, really yearn for those messages and blessings on a daily basis. I'm in recovery. I have 6 months yesterday clean. Thank you. For the first time, I have 3 children. I have a beautiful wife back there. Her name's Alyssa. So Friday morning it was. I had a couple appointments down in Painesville. Pastor Dan asked me to tell you guys how we met. So I had an appointment down in Painesville. As I left one to go to another, I passed the jail. I stopped and I prayed. I pray all the time, on every occasion, every day. So I pray for the people in jail because I remember what that was like. And I don't care what anybody did, and I don't care what anybody's doing. Everybody deserves a relationship with God. Everybody deserves a little joy. So I prayed that they find their peace. They open that book, they work on their relationship with Him, they get back to their families. And as I, as I walk away, and sometimes I get these feelings, maybe sometimes, that I'm not doing enough, or I haven't had a profound miracle or a blessing or a message in a long time, and I will really start to crave those things again, and when they do happen, I'm full of myself, and I just feel so up and great. So I'm in the Dollar Tree as I left from praying at the jail. I'm in the Dollar Tree, and I'm walking through, and I see Pastor Dan. I don't pay him much attention. He says hello, good morning. I'm listening to my worship music, and he says hello. I say hello. I'm walking through the line, and the lady asks me, what I'm listening to, and I told her what I was listening to, and I walk out, and I'm in my own head at the time, and I'm saying, make yourself evident. I need to see you sometime soon. I need to hear from you sometime soon. I need one of those moments. I need you to pop up and say, I see you and I love you and everything's okay, and I really crave those times from Him. So I'm walking across the street, and Pastor Dan stops me, and he says, he says exactly what he told you. He said, you'd make a good bodyguard. You just stand beside me and look mean. He showed me his weapon. I thought that was funny. So I introduced myself, and he said, what's your name? And I told him, my name is Michael. And he said, that's the archangel. And I said, I know, I wear his shield every day, right above the Lord's Prayer. I explained to him that I was a Christian, and he told me who he was. He was a street minister who worked with alcoholics and drug addicts, and that's right up my alley. I said, what made you stop me and talk to me? Because in my head I'm thinking, I needed this right now. I need this all the time, but right now I really needed it. And he said, well, the Spirit told me he told me I needed to say hi. I needed to approach you. And we spoke a little bit, and I told him, I said, I'm kind of looking for, not really religious, I'm spiritual. And somebody told me a while back, they said, religion is for people who are scared to go to hell. Spirituality is for people who have already been there. I follow Jesus. I don't call it religion, I just call it a way of life. I'm a Christian man. And that's all I do. I read my Bible. I get to know the Father. I understand grace. I understand the sacrifice. And that's what I believe in. And he said, well, you know, that's what we do. And he explained where he was. And I've been looking for a church and a place to go. And you know, the timing was right. The message was right. And so I'm here today. And after I spoke to Pastor, you know, I called my wife immediately and I told her, I said, you know, this is what happened. And she knows how I am with just things lining up and messages. And I said, you know, obviously we're going there Sunday. We have to, like, this, you know, this means something. And she said, what's his name? And I said, his name's Pastor Dan. And I told her, he said, street minister. And she said, that's funny because there was a pastor. Now I'm in Painesville. Her mom works in Wycliffe. I think that's where she was at the time. She said, well, there was a man that fits that description that was just in my mother's work, you know, last year, a little bit less than a year ago, who gave her a Bible and spoke to her, and he even wrote a message to my wife and to my middle son, Abel, in the Bible. So, you know, just everything just lined up so well, and we're here today. Alyssa is in the blue, my oldest son, Aiden, in the back, my firstborn. So that's my story. Recovering addict who's in love with the Lord, who has made it his, you know, lifelong, you know, journey to get closer and closer. And, you know, I'm trying to get my family involved. I'm trying to get my wife involved and my sons involved. And I'm taking little steps every day, you know, steps like coming here today. And I appreciate Pastor Dan inviting me. And your wife is amazing. And everybody here is so kind and beautiful. And, you know, praise the Lord. Amen.
You can't make this stuff up, guys. You can't make it up. 1 year ago, about like one to another Dollar Tree, and there they were coming out. There's something about these Dollar Trees.
Tell your family. Tell